INS Udaygiri F-35, the second ship of Project 17A Stealth Frigate, has been delivered to the Indian Navy. Designed by the Warship Design Bureau and built at Mazagon Dock Shipbuilders Limited in Mumbai, this advanced warship is part of India's ambitious naval modernization effort. Named after a mountain range in state of Andhra Pradesh, the warship symbolizes the Indian Navy's growing self-reliance and power projection capabilities. A major milestone in Indian naval shipbuilding, Udaygiri was constructed using modular techniques, a method that allows different sections of the ship to be built simultaneously and then assembled together. This approach significantly reduced construction time and improved quality control. The ship was launched on May 17, 2022, and delivered to the Navy on July 1, 2025, marking one of the fastest build cycles for an Indian frontline warship. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how potent is India's new stealth frigate INS Udaygiri. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. INS Udaygiri was developed under Project 17A, the follow-on to the Project 17 on Shivalik-class frigates. These new-generation warships build upon the experience of the Shivalik-class with improved stealth, weapon systems, and digital integration. Compared to its predecessors, Udaygiri's hull form is more optimized for stealth and seakeeping, and it boasts greater automation to reduce crew workload. The hull uses indigenously developed DMR-249A, steel ensuring both durability and stealth. More than 75% of the ship's components are sourced domestically, involving over 200 Indian companies, including many micro, small, and medium enterprises, MSMEs. This level of indigenization aligns with the government's Make in India and Atmanirbhar Bharat, Self-Reliant India initiatives. It has a length of approximately 149 meters, beam of 17.8 meters, and a displacement of around 6,670 tons. The warship has a combined diesel or gas, CODOG configuration, powered by two General Electric LM2500 plus gas turbines and two manned diesel 12V2833 DSTC engines. The warship has a speed in excess of 52 kilometers per hour or 32 miles per hour and range of about 10,200 kilometers or 6,340 miles. The propulsion system enables high-speed movement when required and fuel-efficient cruising for long-range operations. The ship's endurance makes it suitable for extended missions in the Indian Ocean region and beyond. A core feature of INS Udaygiri is its low observable design. The ship incorporates radar absorbent materials, angled surfaces, and flush mounted equipment to reduce radar cross section. Exhaust systems are designed to lower the infrared signature, while the hull and propellers are engineered to minimize noise and vibration. Such stealth characteristics enhance the frigate's survivability by reducing the likelihood of detection and targeting by enemy platforms. The ship also includes extensive fire suppression, damage control, and compartmentalization to sustain operations under battle conditions. The warship can accommodate around 226 personnel. INS Udaygiri is outfitted with sophisticated sensors and combat management systems to ensure superior situational awareness and battle management. The main radar is the ELM2248MF Star ESA radar, which is capable of simultaneously tracking multiple air and surface targets and guiding missiles. It is complemented by Indra TASL Lanza NL band air surveillance radar. Bow-mounted sonar, HUMSA NG, provides active and passive detection of submarines, whereas towed array sonar ATS enables hostile submarine detection over a wider range. The Combat Management System, CMS 17A, integrates all sensors and weapons for coordinated response and target engagement. Integrated Platform Management System, IPMS, allows centralized monitoring and control of the ship's propulsion, power, HVAC, heating, ventilation, and air conditioning, as well as damage control. A Janta electronic warfare suite incorporates radar warning receivers, jammers, and decoy systems for defensive countermeasures. All systems are linked through advanced data networks that provide the crew with real-time tactical information and automated threat response. INS Udaygiri is equipped with an array of modern weapon systems that allow it to conduct anti-air, anti-surface, and anti-submarine warfare operations effectively. 76mm OTO Malera naval gun installed on the bow is suitable for both air and surface threats. 8-cell VLS for BrahMos. Supersonic cruise missiles is present for land attack and anti-ship operation. The ship has a layered defense and strike capability, making it a versatile asset in any naval task force. INS Udaygiri has a full-length flight deck and an enclosed hangar that can accommodate up to 2 multi-role helicopters. These are typically either the HAL Dhruv or the Sea King, used for reconnaissance, ASW, or logistics. The onboard helicopters extend the ship's sensor range and strike envelope, especially in ASW operations. They can also deploy torpedoes, depth charges, or even conduct search and rescue missions. The ship represents a modern approach to surface warfare, blending firepower, survivability, and automation in a compact, efficient design. INS Udaygiri is not just a warship. It is a symbol of India's maritime ambitions, technological capability, and strategic foresight. By incorporating stealth features, modern weaponry, advanced automation, and a high degree of indigenization, it sets a new benchmark for surface combatants in the Indian Navy. The 7 frigates are to be jointly constructed by 2 public sector shipyards, namely MDL and GRSE, with 4 of the frigates allotted to MDL and the remaining 3 allotted to GRSE. As the Indian Ocean region becomes increasingly contested and strategically vital, ships like Udaygiri will play a central role in protecting national interests, ensuring maritime security, and contributing to global peace efforts. The presence of BrahMos will enable it to take on much larger adversaries if such scenario arise. With more ships of the Nilgiri class following soon, India's position as a formidable naval power continues to strengthen.